Hi, I'm Eric Kunz, Senior Product Manager with Furuno.
And I'm Clayton Patterson with Technical Support.
And on today's Furuno Connection episode, we're going to talk about transducers. The mystery part of the system that everyone has to figure out or at least buy when you're putting in a system that has either sonar or echo sounder or even depth and temperature capabilities.
Yeah.
So these are the important things. There's always a million questions from our customers and even from our technical staff saying, you know, what kind of power do I need for to target this species at this depth? Can I change the frequency? Can I reduce the power in shallow water? There's a lot of questions that we're just, you know, that have to do with specific applications on specific vessels.
Yeah, and obviously we could talk about and ask those questions all day long, but we're never gonna get anywhere. That's why we have two experts from Airmar Technologies to help us understand all that and get a better idea of what we need and what we don't need. So let's bring them in, Pete and Chris from Airmar.
All right.
Hey guys, thanks for having us.
All right.
Good to see you both.
Thanks, guys, for being here.
We really appreciate you inviting us in here.
And
as you mentioned, there's a lot of mystery around transducers. I think when people go to shows and they look at the sonar displays and all those are the easy choices to make. When it comes down to the transducer, there's a lot of decisions to make, a lot of different performance levels. So first, Chris can tell us a little bit about who Airmar is.
Yeah, so Airmar, again, based out of Milford, New Hampshire. We are a transducer company, but our core competency is really in the marine industry, sonar technology, which we're here to talk about today. A lot of people just think of Airmar as the marine industry transducers, but we also make some other air sensing transducers.
Well, you know, everybody, you know, we know everybody knows the name. Everybody's seen it in different places, and they've bought Airmar technology transducers before and installed them, but nobody ever really knows what's going on there, it seems.
Yeah, and so, that's a good point is that, you know, one thing that people don't consider is that there's a lot of different performance levels, there's a lot of different construction, different transducer options available. For instance, this particular model that we partnered with you on has the 3D, has a basic level 1 kilowatt transducer, and then you can step up to something here that has a separate array for the low frequency, individual element for the high frequency, more power, more performance.
The important part here, what we're talking about, is that these are actual combination transducers that we've partnered with Airmar and developed so that every element gets the best place on the boat. You don't have to drill two holes.
That's a good point.
You don't have to make different concessions for performance based on where the best place on the boat is. So these combo transducers incorporate our 165 kilohertz multi-beam, that's 8-channel array DFF3D system, as well as a 200 kilohertz 1 kilowatt element and a 50 kilohertz 7 kilowatt element. So you, or 7 element 1 kilowatt transducer. So the nice thing about this system is that we can put all these transducers into a single housing, get it mounted on the best place on the boat. And that's the important thing,
that's
because
key.
Transducer placement is key to performance. And you'll see how it looks on this 39CV, where we've gone from a smaller B260 1 kilowatt transducer to a new big dog combination 2 kilowatt DFF3D mid and low frequency combination transducer.
All right, guys, let's talk some transducer basics. Now, a lot of you, as we've talked about before, that there's a big mystery question mark over transducers, sounders, and installations. What kind of frequency do I need? What kind of beam width? How deep are you going? All those kind of things are huge questions that a lot of people don't just have the answers to. So let's go through and just kind of give the viewers a rundown of what all that stuff means. What is important about beam width, beam angle, frequency, all that kind of stuff?
Well, let's start with frequency.
Okay.
That seems to be one of the most sought after answers there.
Oh yeah.
Typically, I use analogies of a speaker. If you look at a speaker, the tweeter is going to give you your high definition, your real good detail. It's very directional. Doesn't read very deep. I mean, if you're going to walk away from a speaker, you're going to lose the tweeter first. So it doesn't penetrate very far. Low frequency would typically be used for your depths. It's going to range very far, like a subwoofer.
Yeah, you're going to
you'd hear that car driving by and that thump, 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 but you're not getting detail out of it.
Okay.
Now, one of the things that we've done, like in this Mac Daddy product here, is added a medium band chirp.
Okay.
So chirp gave us the ability to put a frequency right in that middle. So it gives you very good range. So it gives you similar performance to a low frequency when it comes to depth range, but it gives you similar performance to a high frequency when it comes to resolution.
That's
now,
a great
one of the caveats, though, is when you add power. So this is a 2 kilowatt transducer. When you add power, you typically narrow the beam of the transducer down, reducing coverage error slightly.
Yeah.
So.
And that's the magic of the DFF3D at 165 kilohertz. So it's higher frequency, but the beam coverage is multi-beam. So we can steer this pattern through the water and get that full 120-degree coverage, which is huge, at high frequency, maintaining the resolution. So you pass over three times as much information, and you're getting three times as much information on your screen for the same coverage area. It's
what's
amazing.
What's the maximum width at a depth like
so that? So that maximum width is a function of depth. So as you go deeper, but the important thing is if you look at a 120-degree sweep versus a 40-degree ultra-wide sweep, you're getting three times the coverage. That's the basic number you need to understand. So you're going to see fish. You're going to see targets on the bottom, wrecks, structure that you just won't see in a single pass with every other system on the market.
That's impressive. It's huge. That's impressive.
And really, I mean, when you think of beamwidth, an easy way to think of it is a mag light. If you've got that mag light and you narrow that all the way down, you're looking at something in your in your backyard, you know, you're able to see that very clearly. A lot of target definition. But once you start opening up that mag light and broadening the beam, then you start losing some of that clarity, and you're not able to see as far. So think of that same thing with the transducer. I mean, you're going to lose some of that coverage, you know,
resolution
a
little bit.
When you go to a narrow beam,
typically
you won't be able to go as far down.
But you get the same amount of power.
Thumping harder. Exactly. Right.
So here's, you know, to give them a little bit of the audience a little bit of an example. So say I'm deep drop fishing. I'm in 3,500 feet of water. Now, what kind of frequency and beam angle would I need to do any kind of damage and catch some stuff?
So typically when you're deep dropping, you're going to have to narrow up that beam a little.
Okay.
But you're also going to want a low frequency to get down to that depth of the 3,500
feet. So you can really thumb through the water column.
So when you go up to a higher, you know, upper water column, you're going to want to have a high frequency for all that target definition and clarity, but you're going to want maybe a wider beam to see, have that coverage under your boat.
So if I was in, like, for example, like a lake at about 250 feet, well, that's
point right there is we get that question all the time. South Florida, captain will call us up and we'll say, what type of fishing do you do? Well, today I could be in 30 feet fishing for, you know, a certain species, tomorrow in 500, and 3 days later I'm 2,800 feet
Swordfishing.
So that's the advantage to a product like this, is that to typically, you know, for that high water column, you're going to want a lot of beam coverage. You're going to want high frequency for the detail. For that deep dropping, you're going to need a low frequency. And as you mentioned, you've got your high frequency in your 3D multi-beam. You've got your medium frequency and your low frequency. So literally, any type of fishing that angler could possibly encounter, this transducer will cover.
This will work not just for recreation guys, but also for the commercial guys, too.
Absolutely.
The DFF 3D has the stabilization built into this product.
That's true.
So you mount it wherever you want, and there's no setup or configuration.
It has the motion sensor already in it.
Exactly. So it's super easy.
Personally, I think the combination of putting all of this stuff in the same package is absolutely brilliant. And you're not going to see it anywhere else.
You save money, and you get the best of both worlds.
Exactly. So hopefully, that'll give you a pretty decent idea as to, you know, what you guys need to keep in mind as far as installing a transducer, you know, what to buy, what frequencies, what beam angles, you know, what to put in the boat so you get the best performance no matter what you're trying to do. So thanks for watching, and if you like the exciting content that you've seen, click the link below to like the video and subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you'll be the first one to know when we have new content available with new product information and new exciting stuff from Furuno.